Welcome to My Avtar, My Identity, a series where we explore the amazing stories of people who have broken that so-called diversity stereotype and risen to the top of their professions. In this series, we hope to listen and share thoughts with people who have not allowed those biases and those boxes to define them. I hope through this series, we all are inspired to reach to the fullest of our potential and not listen to how the world defines us. Because it's my avatar, my identity. It's a gorgeous day, and it has to be. It is International Women's Day today. And for this episode, the inaugural episode of the My Avatar series, I have with me an equally gorgeous woman, the Chief Human Resources Officer of Citi South Asia, Shweta Mehrotra. Welcome to the show, Shweta, and a very happy International Women's Day to you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Saundarya, and a very happy International Women's Day to you as well, and to everyone out there watching this.
Thank you. I'm just going to jump right in and ask you the first question of today's program. Shweta, the young girl, paint us a word picture.
So when I was growing up, I was like this little girl with big dreams in those little eyes, where I wanted to do a lot of things, had the passion and the drive, and wanted to make, you know, a lot of difference in the world. So that's really how I was when I was growing up. And I was born in a family where we were three girls. And I was born at a time where it mattered to have sons. And despite that, I feel that my parents really brought us up in the best possible way and giving us the best education and exposure which was available out there. And that's been a very important foundation of who I am today. And that's why I feel so passionately about this agenda.
Yeah. Shweta, how did you experience diversity?
So I have been privileged to be working in an organization which promotes mobility. So I got the option to move from Mumbai into Hong Kong. And it was a phenomenal experience.
Okay.
It gave me the opportunity to work with people from very different walks of life, different cultures, different backgrounds, different countries. It's a real melting pot. And it really opened my perspective. It helped me grow personally and professionally. I think the advantage I had and which helped me really settle so quickly over there was India is so diverse. And you don't realize that you're already dealing with this in so many ways every day.
Beautiful.
So that is really what helped me as I transitioned from here into Hong Kong.
I totally get it. But how would you think, this experience of diversity kind of molded your worldview or your capacity as a professional?
So what happens is that when you have people who have come from very different walks of life, who think differently, they come in to the table to brainstorm a problem from very different perspectives.
Yes.
And when you have all of that thinking on the table, all of those perspectives on the table, what you end up with is much better decisions.
Oh, yes.
And that totally made me a convert on, you know, why is inclusion so important? What's the value of inclusion? And how can it play such a big role in making the right decisions and making the more thought through decisions for organizations?
That's just so beautiful. I think you just touched upon this very important concept of cognitive diversity. You know, where we bring different problem solving techniques, different thought processes, different life journeys, to the table. And I think that's just brilliant. Be the advice that you would give your younger self, Shweta?
So there are three things I would say.
Okay.
I think the first is that growth and comfort usually do not coexist. So the day you start to feel very settled in what you're doing, very comfortable in what you're doing, you need to ask this question saying, are you really growing? Is it time to really do something different, take a bigger challenge? The second thing I would say is take some chances. take some risks. Because if you don't take a risk on yourself, who will? And this is something one of my bosses said this to me many years back, and it has just stayed with me. The third thing I would say is focus on building your toolkit. Okay. So look at experiences which help you truly grow and develop. At the end of the year, ask yourself this question, that has the year helped you gain some more skills or capabilities as you're progressing in your career? So think about building your toolkit, because that's going to take you far.
You know, I really must say this. You are a minority in the Indian workplace today. And you know why I say that? That's because for a young HR leader, you know, to rise to the top of a profession, that's just probably 10% at your level, you know, of women who are there and who have made it so successfully. I must ask you this. What were those enablers? What kind of helped you in this journey to where you are now?
So what I would say, Saundarya, is that behind every man, as they say, there is a woman. Okay. Behind every successful man, there's a woman. Uh-huh. Behind every successful woman, there are many men and women who make it happen. Okay. And that's been the story of my life as well. Right. I have many people to thank as I have come along this journey. Let me start by talking about my maternity leave.
Okay.
You know, I had a premature child. I came back from maternity leave and needed a lot of support. And I had a fantastic manager who really, I have so much to thank him for in terms of being understanding, being empathetic to my needs at that time and helping me traverse this journey. The other set I would say that has really made a difference is the mentors I have had along the way. They have been around to guide me, to help me, to reach out, to look out for me as I have traversed this journey. I have reached out to them, and when they feel I need them or they have that sense, they reach out they lend a helping hand. So they are, you know, they have been instrumental. And last but not the least, I think for women, one of the very important decisions you make is choosing the right partner.
Yes.
Because you have to have a supportive spouse to do this all. So I have been lucky on that front as well. I have had a very supportive spouse who's made this possible to get me this far. And you know, I think to top it all, the organization makes a huge amount of difference. You know, I have been fortunate that the organization that I've worked with has been very, very supportive of this agenda. This is my avatar, my identity. And here is a shout out to all you women out there to go write your future and make your dreams come true.
So many thought-provoking and mesmerizing ideas about how women can absolutely reach to the fullest of their potential only if they are intentional. Stay tuned to My Avatar, My Identity, where we bring you many, many more inspiring people who have broken those shackles and absolutely made a world entirely by themselves. Thank you.